go before the Lord in prayer tonight, open up the service tonight. Let's just ask God to have His way. Heavenly Father, Lord God, as we come to You once again, God, we thank You, Lord God, for another opportunity, God, to be able to be in Your house, God, and be able to give You praise and be able to lift You up tonight. And God, we just pray, God, that You would have Your way in this place tonight, God. I pray, Lord God, that You would open up the windows of heaven and pour out Your Spirit upon this place, God, and begin to bless, Lord, let Your Holy Ghost fall upon this place tonight. I pray, God, that You would anoint the singing, Lord. I pray, God, that You would anoint everything in this service tonight. And God, we give You praise. God, we give You glory. We give You honor. I pray, God, those out there that's by watching my live stream tonight, I pray, God, that You would get a hold of their hearts tonight. And God, get a hold of them, Lord, and shake them, Lord. And let them realize, God, that they need to find You. And God, that they need to give their life over to You tonight. And God, we just pray that You would have Your way in this service. I pray, God, that You would open the ears of the people tonight and let them hear what the Spirit was saying to the church tonight. And God, we give You praise for this. And God, we give You glory. We thank You for those that's here tonight. And God, we just ask, God, that You would bless tonight in a mighty way. And God, we give You all the praise and all the glory. And the church is saying amen. Hallelujah. Those that want to come help Nora sing tonight, Houston, Cassie, Tanya, Jeremy, y'all want to come and help tonight, y'all come on up the hill.
If y'all get hot back there, y'all can come out and stuff. Anybody want a book?
Oh,
This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. She sung earlier this morning, she said, this is the church that the Lord has made.
Amen.
Glory to God, and I thank God, Brother Wayne, for what God is doing. Thank God for what he's going to do. A lot of people says, well, Brother Miller, how do you know what God's going to do? Because I know God. I know God, and I know God's going to do great things. Glory to God. He said he would do great things, Brother Daniel. Hallelujah. I appreciate him tonight. I love him. Glory to God. Let's remember Sister Kathy Levi tonight. She's sick. Nora's going to stand in for her here in a little bit. And she wanted Nora to stand in prayer for her. But this sickness is going around. It's getting a lot of people. And it's knocking them down, Sister Rita. But I tell you what, we know the healer.
Amen.
We know the one that we can call on. When we need him, we can call him. I was reading a thing last night on the internet, and he said, there's one thing I found out. If I call on God, his line's never busy. I can call him any time of the day, and he'll answer. You might not think he answers, but he answers. Glory to God, he said, I hear the cries of the people that cries to him. He hears our cries. And I appreciate the Lord tonight. We're going to take up prayer requests tonight. Anybody that's got a prayer request, just mention it and let it be known.
Remember the church. Remember that we're this church is here and open for the glory of God. To see souls saved, to see souls helped, to see backsliders come back. For all for God's glory.
Amen. Somebody else.
Just remember the people that died in the plane crash out there in the Austin area, and remember our soldiers overseas fighting for our freedom. Because
Amen.
If they weren't over there fighting for our freedom, we wouldn't have freedom of religion and freedom of speech or any of them on the Constitution.
That's right. Amen. Let's remember that tonight. Somebody else. Remember my lost loved ones. I got lost loved ones, and I will see them saved. Because I know that one day, after a while, the Bible said that if you live upright before him, that he would save your whole household. And my mom and dad lived the best that they know how before God. And my brothers are going to have to bow one day and accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior. If not, they're still going to bow one day at his feet. And it's going to be too late then, Brother Joe. But let's remember them tonight. Anybody else?
Remember the girl that done my hair tonight, Beth Ann. She's fighting pneumonia.
Amen. Somebody else? Amen. Let's remember that. Somebody else tonight.
I just want to remember all our veterans that fought for us, and just wish them the best that they can. As of the parade yesterday with all them older veterans out there packing around the heavy combat boots and everything, and I just want to pray that they'll be fine and safe, and
continue
to praise the Lord.
Amen. Just remember that, because they had fought for our country. I was thinking yesterday about Brother Bill Kinslow, how he fought on Normandy when he went there and he sat in Hitler's chair. Sister Bonnie, he kept saying, that was my chair. I went there and I sat in that chair. We run old Hitler out. He said, I was there. He said, man, our sergeant told us, he said, you dig you a foxhole and you stand your ground. Don't you give up. Don't you give in. Don't you even let your guard down. You stand still. And the Bible tells us to do the same thing. He said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. In other words, you stand still. When you've done all that you can do, he said, then stand. Hallelujah. Anybody else got a prayer request?
Fought for our country, and, you know, we can pay people to put a basketball through a hoop, which is pretty much, you know, I can do that throwing something in a trash can. You know, you got people playing football and, you know, baseball, that's just a stick and a rock. You know, you got all these people who pay millions of dollars just to entertain people, but then you can't keep up the people that fought for that freedom. Remember them. I just want to thank the Lord for being the ultimate veteran, paying the price, not necessarily for our country, but for our life, for our sin.
Amen.
You know, God knew that we wouldn't be able to bear it, so he sent his one and only son to bear it all.
That's right.
You know, there's a lot of people been in this world since the beginning of time. And, you know, Jesus died. And, you know, Jesus took everything for all of our sin. He bore it all because God knew we couldn't do it. So I thank him for being the ultimate veteran. And all, I'm not trying to take nothing from the regular veterans, but you know, a lot of people don't realize, think about that and realize that. But
amen.
I just thank you for being the ultimate veteran.
Amen. Yes, he was. He was offering a sacrifice for us. Amen. Anybody else tonight? Nieces and my nephews. Connie's boy, he's fixing to have surgery. And, you know, we need to pray for them, that God will get a hold of them, God will save their souls. And because they got praying mamas and praying daddy that's praying for him. And my nieces and my nephews, I've been praying for them a lot. I've been praying hard for my family. Not only my family and Nora's family, I've been praying for them. I give them to God, Brother Austin. That's all I can do is give them to God. So let's remember that tonight. Any unspoken request by raising your hand, you can come around the altar or even pray at your seat. Bless you, Lord God, as we come to you once again. God, we thank you, God, for this thing. God, we thank you, Lord God, for these requests, God, that we're giving in, God. God, I pray, God, you remember our veterans, Lord God, those, God, that fought for our country, Lord God, and those that are fighting for our country right now, God, I pray, God, you be with them, God. Lord God, that you would help them, Lord God, lead them and guide them, God, and keep them safe, Lord God. I know there's a lot of mom and daddies are worried about their sons and daughters being over there fighting, God. Lord God, we pray, God, our first responders, Lord God, that you would be with them, God. Lord God, we ask, God, that you remember these needs, these requests, God. God, little Sierra, God, you touch her body, Lord. Lord God, the devil's a liar and a father of it, and we rebuke him in the name of Jesus. God, we bind him right now. God, we curse it, Lord. God, we know, God, that you touched that little child, God. And Lord God, we pray that you would, Lord, lift her up, Lord God, tonight, God. I pray, Lord God, that you would move in this service in a mighty way. I pray, God, that your glory would fall upon this place. I pray, God, that the Holy Ghost would come in this place tonight. And Lord God, shake this place. Lord, shake them tonight. Lord, let them feel this kind of glory, God, come down upon them. God, we thank you for that soul that came back to the Lord this morning. And Lord God, we just pray, God, God, that you would have your way. Lord, bless the singing. Lord, bless the preaching tonight. I bless Brother Wayne, anoint him tonight, God. With a special anointing, God. Heavenly Father, God, we just praise the Lord. God, we thank you for everything that you mean to us, God.
God, remember our little church, God. God, we ask God that you would just keep blessing it. God, keep blessing sin and lost souls in, God. God, send them in, God. We ask God, we thank you, God. Oh, God, for what you've been doing, what you're going to do. God, because we give you thanks for it, God. We give you glory, God. God, we want to worship you tonight in spirit and in truth, God. God, to give you praise and to give you honor, God. God, we thank you for it, God, in Jesus' precious and holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God. I asked Mr. Daniel to sing for us tonight. Well, you was outside. I asked him if yes, y'all would. So, y'all pray for them as they come and sing.
Thank you.
the 10th of December, we'll have Thanksgiving / Christmas dinner at Misty's house, Misty and Daniel's house. Or Daniel's house, he said. So we're having it at Daniel's house. And if you would like to come, you're more than welcome to come to us. We're bringing just a covered dish. We done got the turkey donated to it. God's done give us the turkey, so we don't have to worry about that.
She's got a big kitchen and a big
and
living room.
Yeah, she's got a big kitchen, a big living room, and dining room. And Josh's daddy last night bought us the turkey, so we give him thanks for that. See, God supplies your needs.
Amen.
You know, we didn't say nothing about it. God just supplies our needs. Remember Sister Tanya's can drive. If you got a few canned goods you want to just bring here to the church, we can give to her, because that is something good. I mean, we can go out and buy a few cans and put them in a sack and bring them in and help somebody that's hungry, help somebody that needs something this holiday. You know, that's what the holidays is about, is giving. And if a church can't give to help somebody, to help them, feed them, and things, there's something wrong somewhere. And it don't matter, just bring a few canned goods, what you can bring, God will bless you for it.
Save me what you want to bring to the dinner.
Yeah. See, Cassie, she'll write all that stuff down.
And everybody's not bringing the same thing.
We got a bake sale the 18th, next Saturday at Houchins.
8 a.m.
And just whatever you want to bake and bring, donate, that's fine. We had somebody come to our house the other day and brought some stuff to us to use for bake sale. They said, we see y'all's having a bake sale, so we want to bring y'all something. So they brought it to the house and give it to us. So see, God makes a way. They see it. Sister Rita, and they just come and say, hey, we got some stuff we want to give y'all to use for your bake sale. So we thank God for that. We praise Him for it.
Also, Sister Emily texted me today earlier. I asked her about where another place y'all could bring canned food. I don't know where this is at. It's Moore's Market on 249. She said you can take it up there and give it to her, and she can take it up to the house.
You mean?
Sure, with you in, you never thought this battle over.
the Lord. Hope for the crippled man to rise and walk again. Hallelujah. Same for us. Last Austin and Brother James come up and take up our offering tonight. These are my ushers. Y'all don't realize I adopted them. Brother Adam, you want to ask bless the Lord offering?
Heavenly Father, Lord, we just ask you to bless this offering tonight. Lord, we just ask you to touch each and every one that can give them what they can't give. Lord, we just ask you to touch them as we go with the service. Lord, we just thank you for what you did. We keep the church to
pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Back there.
Amen. Ain't it good to be here tonight?
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Bless you tonight, Lord Jesus.
You know, as the song says, I can see my Savior. You know, come on.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
It's going to be a good day for the saints of God, Brother Dave.
That's right.
Come on. But those that are lost and undone without the Lord.
Yeah, come on, Brother Wayne.
You know, it's going to be a sad day for them.
Yeah, come on.
God cared so much for us, Brother David, that
yeah.
He sent His only begotten Son
yes.
to take the sins of this world so that you and I can have life and have it more
yes.
abundantly today, friend.
Yep.
And I don't understand why people won't heed
come on.
To the warning call.
Come on.
Signs that are out there, you know, you hear them cows, the tornado be coming.
Yes.
Or warnings, level the sound that warning sound that cow. Woo! 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 Yeah, preachers in the pulpit sounding the warning call today.
Yeah.
You know, Brother David, you know, all you gotta do is watch the local news.
Yeah.
You know, that's all you got to do is just watch the local news, friend.
Yeah.
And you'll see the time's running out. If we make it to the end of this year, friend, I'll be very surprised. And I know if we see the end of next year, I will definitely be surprised.
Yeah.
Because there's a Savior. There's a man called Jesus Christ. And God's going to look at him and he's going to say, son, my children have died. I'm telling you, go get them and bring them home. Bring them home. He said he's going to come and get us. He found a way to prepare a place for us. That place is just not finished, friend.
Come on.
If it's your time to go, you're going to go.
Yeah.
It don't matter. Happy Lord. Bless you. God poured on him tonight. Hallelujah.
Help him, Lord.
Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus. Friend, we're not here to put on no show.
Right?
We're here. Like I said, look, we love people.
Yes.
We don't care what kind of sin you're doing.
Right? Come on.
We love you.
Amen.
Jesus bared them sins on that cross.
Yes, he did.
Amen.
He came over 2,000 years ago.
Yeah.
To give you life.
Right?
And give it more abundantly.
Come on.
Yeah.
They want to say,
bless the Lord.
We killed him. No, you didn't.
Uh-huh.
No, you didn't. He
Come on.
Gave.
Yes, he did.
He gave.
Come yes, on. He did.
The Father said he gave his only begotten
Son. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what's wrong today. Believing too many lies.
Come on.
Come on.
The devil will get in here and say,
bless him, Lord. Come on.
Now, this is my wife. I can talk to her.
Come on.
Now, you know, the husband, you're seeing a little fat old man. Now, honey, that man down the road there, he's all slim, prim.
Come on.
Got a six pack.
Yeah.
He's got an arm about 32 inches wide.
Come on.
That's what he'll do.
Yeah.
That's what he'll do.
Yes.
Say, well, ain't you crazy? Well, why not be crazy for Jesus?
That's right.
They died on a tree.
Yes, he did.
Amen.
Yes, he did.
For our sins.
Yes.
Amen.
He said, wait, how many times you going to say that? As many as the Lord lays it on my heart.
That's right. Right.
Amen.
It don't matter if I say it one or if I say it 100.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, come on.
God wants somebody to know he loves them tonight.
Yes. That's right.
And that he died for your sins.
Yes. Amen.
And he's wanting to bring you to an altar.
Yes.
He's wanting to bring you to him where you rightly belong. Instead of out here in the world where you don't belong. The world can offer everything in the world, man. But there's one thing it can't offer you, and that's peace. That's peace like you've never had before. Peace. Oh, we need to lay down tonight and look up at the ceiling. That's it. If I wake up in the morning, praise God.
Amen.
If I don't wake up here, praise God.
Yeah.
Because the first thing I see when I get over there,
right,
is a man called Jesus.
Right.
Right. He's gonna have a scar in his hand.
Yeah.
A scar in his hand.
Yeah.
And scars in his feet.
Yeah.
A scar in his side.
Yeah.
And some scars in his forehead.
Yeah.
And you know what he's going to do? He's going to put that arm around you.
Yeah.
Help him, Lord.
He's going to say, you made it home.
Amen.
You made it home. Nothing wrong with that.
Hey, baby.
That's just the enemy of life.
Bless
the
Lord.
It's in the name of the Lord. Say,
help
the
Lord.
Bless
you,
Lord.
Why are you sitting down, Lord? Don't worry about it. God knows.
Amen.
I know I've been warned.
Come on.
But if I did this, that somebody was going to get me.
Come on.
Don't let it offend you.
Come on.
Because you know why?
Help him, Lord.
If it offends you, that's just a trick of the devil.
Amen. Amen.
Trying to get your mind on it. You and me,
right.
As long as we accept him,
right.
And we walk up right before him.
Come on.
Bless the Lord.
Bless
the
Lord.
Let's call upon his name.
Bless the Lord.
Come on.
Now.
Bless him.
We'll talk about heaven.
Yes.
Now, I just thank you, Jim. Thank you, buddy.
Come on.
You know, Brother David?
Bless
him. Hallelujah.
Help him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Right before I got back in church, back in 1992, I think that's what it was. Lord, give me a dream.
Bless the Lord.
A man, it wasn't no pretty dream. These satanic devils, worshipers, whatever you want to call them.
Yeah.
Wanted me.
Yeah, come on.
Wanted me.
Yep, Lord.
A man, I was stout back then. I weighed about 260, 280, 90, maybe a little more. And man, I woke up, I was scared to death.
Come on.
Connie was serving the Lord. And I wasn't. But let me tell you where I got. I crawled over close to her as I could. Took her arm. I put her around me. You say, why'd you do that for Wayne? I said, like I said, I was scared to death. I know what she had was going to protect her, and I was praying it was going to protect me to get to her arm. Amen. What I seen was, you know, I seen a cartoon here a while back.
Yep,
and
Lord.
Come on.
It had on a show, come on. No, it was a clean cartoon, you know, it wasn't in these new modern day cartoons where everything comes on. Got something cussing or provocative in it. But there was, I'm thinking it was Tom and Jerry, I may be wrong. Oh, Tommy had nine lives in his cartoon. And this Joe, he was mean, you know, he was mean. And the devil in this cartoon was a dog, Brother Dave. He was standing down there laughing at Jerry. And then it had these flames, these little red pits of like lava and different things. And it had other dogs in there jumping up and down, you know, pitchforks and things and laughing and barking. And Show Tonk, he did something, got killed. And he showed him he was sliding down and sliding in a circle. Down in front of this dog, big old bulldog, and he was a lad. He said, Tom, he said, you got eight lives left, Tom. Go back and let's see if you can do better. And his first life was sitting over on a bench, and he went back. No mind to what that devil told him. He went back doing the same old thing, being mean to Jerry. And here he come again down that slide. And he said, Tom, I told you you had eight lives. Now you've got seven. And you better make up your mind what you're going to do. Well, Tom, I'm not caring, not heeding to the word, like a lot of people in the church.
Right.
A lot of people in the world, like family members.
Right.
Of mine. And yours.
Right.
You know, you tried to warn them, they won't listen.
Yep.
Well, here he comes again, back down that slide. And, you know, and that escalator, one going up, he had a rope across it. And the other one was a slide, like I said, was a slide. And here he come back down the slide again. Anyways, he got to life number eight. And he finally got scared then, because he knew he had one more try.
You know, Brother Dave, ain't no then they wouldn't be in hell.
Yeah.
But he was doing things that he shouldn't do. He was doing everything impossible, you know, that he could.
Help him, Lord.
But it wasn't doing no good. And then here it happened. He done it again.
Help him, Lord.
And here he went. And this was the ninth time he went down there in front of that dog that was the devil. He had his big pitchforks and everything. I'm not telling you this to make something mockery of hell. I'm trying to make an illustration to you, friend.
Lord.
Come to find out, in this story, in this cartoon, Tom was dreaming. And he was laying by the fireplace. Some coals had jumped out of the fire. And it caught his tail on fire. And he woke up. But anyways, when he was at night time, he was going down there. The devil got the pitchfork ready to throw him into the fire. And about that time, that coal hit his tail, and he started jumping up and down. Friend, that's a story.
Yeah.
You know, something fictional. But what we're telling you tonight is something that is fact, and it's real.
Right.
You know, hell was created for the devil and his angels.
Right.
It wasn't made for you or me. It was created for his angels. But the sad part of it is, you and I are causing hell to enlarge each and every day.
Right.
Because we reject the word of God.
Right.
We reject every time.
Bless the Lord.
Knocks on our hearts the wall.
Yeah.
And because of us rejecting God, we're going to take our family with us.
Yeah.
Our kids with us.
All right.
And how in the world can we live with that each and every day here?
Come on.
Because when you get there, friend, that family ain't going to matter to you.
Right.
Because all you're going to be concerned about is getting out of them planes.
Amen.
And once you get there, friend, Satan's going to be waiting. That's and right. He's going to be greeting you there. And then he's going to sit back. And he's going to laugh at you and say,
right.
You big dummy.
Yeah.
I tricked you. I fooled you.
Come on.
You were dumb enough to believe that lie that you had another day.
Amen.
That everything that you had hid from the pastor, from the pastor's wife, from the into heaven.
That's right.
Because once that last breath leaves that body of ours, Brother Joe, it's too late then.
Right.
It's too late. We're either going to wake up on the other side of heaven.
Amen.
We're going to rejoice.
Yeah.
And shouting.
Come on.
And feasting at the Master's table. With loved ones that led us to Jesus.
Amen.
Or we're going to die. And we're going to go to hell.
Right.
With the devil and his angels. There ain't going to be no water there. There ain't going to be no air conditioner there.
Right.
There ain't going to be no fans there.
Right.
All it's going to be is sinners there.
Right.
And ungodly people there.
Right. Yeah.
And all you're going to be doing is weeping.
Wailing.
And gnashing of teeth.
Right.
You say, what about gnashing teeth? You're going to be fighting on one another.
Right.
Because that pain's going to be so terrible there. That it's going to be unbearable. But you can't escape.
Amen.
Because once you get there, you're there. You're there. Why not tonight Start serving the Lord.
Yes.
Start putting Him first in your life.
Right.
If your spouse don't want to go, don't let that spouse take you to hell with them.
That's right.
Come, repent, wherever you are. Repent. And then after you repent, you can pray for them that God will spare them long enough that they'll come in.
That's right.
Sister Nora says she's got a promise that God's going to bring her oldest daughter in. You know, I got a son that's fixing to have some major surgery. And Connie gets upset sometimes. And I do a little bit when I go talking about it. But I know it's in God's hands.
Amen.
And He's done told me a while back, back at the first of the year, that He's going to take care of him.
Amen.
I'll fight a devil in hell and a heartbeat over his soul.
Amen.
You know why? Because I love him.
Right.
And if I love my son that much, how much do you think
That's
Jesus
right.
loves you?
Amen.
He died. He's sitting at the right hand of the Lord.
Yeah. Amen.
And He's waiting for you to come to the foot of the cross. Because tonight, there's still room at the cross. Do you want to be at the foot of the cross?
Amen.
Now? Because once that last breath leaves, it'll be too late.
That's right.
To make room at the foot of the cross.
Right. Yes. Amen. Help him,
Lord.
Bless
him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord. Use him, Lord.
Help him,
Lord.
Use him,
Jesus.
Help him, Lord.
Praise the
Lord. I don't know who this is for, but God does.
That's all right.
Amen. And
help him, Lord.
That's fine.
Bless him, Lord.
You say, well, I'll get on my deathbed.
Help him, Lord.
I'll call. I'll call upon the name of the Lord.
Help him, Lord.
Oh, that's fine. But why take a gamble like that?
Help him, Lord.
Bless him, Jesus.
You know, I worked at the hospital years ago. And you can tell when people were dying, Brother Dave.
Yes, you could.
Some people, you know, you can hear them. And they wouldn't be hollering and carrying on. They'd have your peaceful noise coming out of the room. Down the, and you hear them down the hallway, friend. But now when people that was lost and undone, Brother David, oh, you could hear them.
Yeah, you could. Come on.
And you could hear them loud. They'd go to holler. Friend, I'm not telling you this, and I'm not making it up. I witnessed this different days when I worked out there. You would hear them. They'd be hollering, get that devil away from me. My feet are burning.
Yeah.
Get him away from me. And you know, and I stand there and I just about cry because I know someone's down the road. God had dealt with that person and they rejected him.
Yeah, come on.
And they refused to accept him. But friend, tonight when you leave here, lost and undone, and if you don't make heaven things right with the Lord, I got news for you. Satan's awaiting.
Amen.
Yes.
And when you get there, he's going to laugh at you. I don't like to be laughed at and made fun of. I don't know about you. I'm pretty sure 99% of you don't either.
Heaven, Lord.
But when you get there, it'll be too late.
Amen.
He'll want you. He'll laugh at you.
Amen.
He'll put things in your mind here. Oh, it'll be all right. It'll be all right tomorrow.
Yeah.
Don't pay no attention to what that fat boy is singing.
Yeah. Saying. Come on.
Let go and turn it out to heaven.
Yeah.
Friend, don't turn a deaf ear to God.
Amen.
Tonight might be the last time He knocks at your heart's door.
Amen.
And where will you be after that? On a sad road to hell.
Amen.
Because once He shuts the door of mercy, He's shut.
Amen.
For good.
That's right.
No matter how much you cry, you bawl, you say, Lord, have mercy on me. I remember that night at He's Alive Community Church.
Yeah.
When you dealt with my heart,
yep,
and I rejected you.
Yep.
And you know what He said there in Proverbs, Brother David? He said, I'm going to laugh at your calamity in
yep
the time of trouble.
Yes.
In other words, friend, He's going to sit back and look at you.
Yep.
And He's done washed His hands of you because He's turned you over
amen
to a reprobate man.
Yeah.
Right.
Friend, you're in danger of hellfire if you're that close.
Yep.
Right.
And once you get that close, there ain't no returning.
Right.
God wants you and He wants you to know. He's standing there with His hands out.
Amen.
Brother David, you know, I told you and Sister Moore and Connie
yep
that I had a dream there at the house that was in this cylinder block church.
Yeah.
And I told y'all that this person stood up and said, the Lord is here.
Uh-huh.
And I heard the Lord's voice say to me, He said, I am here. Last Sunday morning, Brother David was a preacher. I was sitting right there. God is my witness. I was sitting there and I was looking right here. Oh, I had to be stupid, Brother David.
Oh.
I had to be stupid. I started seeing a man's feet. A white robe. And I got excited. I didn't get excited to run. I got excited because I wanted to see His face. And it started getting clear, clear, white, white, white. I got up to His waistline. I got so excited. I jerked my head up. And boom, He was gone. I'm like, Lord, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry that I did that. And I'm like, you big stupid idiot. I did. God's my witness. I did that. He's here tonight just as much as He was
amen
there the other day when I saw
amen
Him.
Amen, that's right.
The question is, He's standing with His arms stretched out. Sister Nora, come play a song. As you sit there, you think about where you're going to spend eternity tonight.
Right.
Do you want to go to heaven? Or do you want to let the devil lie to you and take you to hell? And He's going to laugh at you once you get there. I've done my part, now it's time for you to do yours.
Right.
I've done, been done dealing with some people in here. You say, Wayne, how you know it? Because I feel it right here.
Amen.
I feel it here. And when I feel it here, I feel like telling you, God's dealing with some people. Whether you come and pray, my hands are clean. I'll go home tonight and snore like a hog.
Come on.
You know, because I've done what God said to me.
Right.
Amen.
There's no...
Amen.
Amen.
Just as I am in my heart,
I'm
broken.
Yes.
Yes.
place. Just go tell my five brothers not to come here. That's what he told them in the word. He said, Father Abraham sent Lazarus, let him be given the tip of his finger in some water. Tonight, God. They don't realize.
to y'all that wants to come and pray, glory to God, to come on up here and let's lay hands on Nora for Sister Kathy. Glory to God, she's coughing real bad. She said she felt like she had a low-grade fever today. Glory to God, she said she wished she could be here tonight, but she's sick. Glory to God, she wants her NBA, her best friend, to stand in for her tonight. Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God. God, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, God, as we anoint Sister Nora, God, for Sister Kathy tonight, God, I pray, Heavenly Father, God, that you would begin to let that human worship begin to flow through Sister Kathy right now. God, we send the word right now. God, I'm there with her house in Edmonton. God, we send the word. Lord, you dispatch and healing angels down. I just want to thank you, Lord.
you've done in their lives, God. I thank you for it, God. And I praise you for that. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you.
you might be out there tonight and thinking, I ain't got no use of living. I ain't got no use of making it no more. But can I tell you, Jesus said he loved you, that he gave his life for you, that you could live and you could have life more abundantly. But God spoke to me. Brother Raymond said, tell them out there in live stream that he died on the cross so they can be alive today, that they can still live. The devil's lied to you long enough. Somebody out there, the devil has lied to you long enough and told you there's no use. Why don't you just give up? But Jesus said, hold on. Hold on a little longer. Help is on the way. Help is on the way. Hallelujah. Jesus said to tell you that he loved you. He loved you. He went all the way to the cross for you out there today. Hallelujah. Somebody's listening, Brother Josh. Somebody out there is listening. God showed me somebody is listening, and they taking what was said to heart. Give your life to Jesus right now and say, Jesus, I'm sorry of my sins. And he said, I'm faithful and just to forgive you of your sins. Hallelujah. People makes it so hard.
Amen.
They make it so hard to tell you how to get saved. Can I tell you, all Jesus said to do was to believe in your heart that he had rose from the grave, and ask and believe in your heart. And he said, I will forgive you of your sins. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. There might be somebody out there, you got a bottle in your hand, and the devil's saying, just turn it up one more time. Just one more time. And Jesus said, put the bottle down. Just put it down. Just put it down. And pick up that word of God. And begin to read the word of God. Lord, in 3 John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him shall not perish but have life everlasting. Glory to God.
Amen.
There's a song out there that says John 3:16. Tonight old Jack Daniels met John 3:16. Somebody out there needs to hear that tonight. Somebody out there in live stream needs to know. Jack Daniels ain't going to get you nowhere. Glory to God, but Jesus will give you life. He will put a well of water springing up inside of you that'll flow. Glory to God, he'll give you a new body. Glory to God, he'll give you a new life tonight. Hallelujah. Lord, God, all the devil wants to give you is junk. All the devil wants to give you is lies. There's somebody might be listening, your home is splitting up. And the devil's telling you, why don't you just take a gun and blow your brains out, because nobody loves you. But Jesus said to tell you, he loves you. He's standing with his arms outstretched for you right now. Right now, he's standing out there with his arms outstretched. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You say, Brother Miller, you don't know that. Yes, I do. I feel it in my spirit. I feel it in my spirit. Glory to God. I feel it right here, Brother Joe. I feel it right here. Glory to God. Somebody out there. Glory to God. You said, I can't make it no more. I just can't make it no more. I might as well just lay it all down. I might as well just give it up. Glory to God. Jesus said, don't give it up.
Right.
He said, don't give me up. Don't give me up. Well, the church has hurt me. People have hurt me. But Jesus said, I've never hurt you. He said, I loved you. I loved you from the beginning. I have loved you.
Right.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, you don't almost see come to the Lord. Bless
you, Lord. Come on, Lord. Bless you. Hallelujah.
Jesus said to tell you, Glory to God that your mama still loves you. Jesus said for me to tell you that your daddy still loves you. You might think you run away from home, but Jesus said to tell you that your mom and daddy still loves you. We're just waiting for you to come home. Brother Josh, there was a boy in the Bible. Glory to God, his father told him, he come to his father, and he said, Father, give me my portion of my goods. He said, I want my share, and I'm going to go out here and live it up. What I want to do. But God said there's somebody out there just like the prodigal son or the prodigal daughter. You said, I want to go out here and just sow my wild oats. I just wanted to go out here and live it up. And now I'm homeless. I ain't got no home. My mom and daddy don't love me no more. Oh, but Jesus said that they love you. He said that they're standing waiting for you to come home. He said they're waiting for you to come. And knock on the door, pick up the phone, call your mama and daddy, say, Mama, I love you, I want to come home.
Come on.
Yeah, I've seen it. knows who you are. And you know exactly who you are tonight. He said, I've seen you call upon my name. People hasn't seen it, but I have. And I almost become sad. You might be out there in live stream tonight, and you've been praying to God in secret. He said, I've seen it, and I've heard your prayers. You might think, well, no, he ain't heard my prayers. My prayers ain't doing no good. But see, people don't know what you've been praying for. People don't know what you've been asking God for. People might say, well, you just can't do it. But God said, yes, you can. He don't almost sit out of my soul. Brother Joe, I feel it in my spirit tonight. God just revealed it to me a while ago. Somebody. Wayne, I don't know who it is, and it's not none of my business. That's between them and God.
Right.
That's between you and God. But God said to say, child, I've heard that prayer.
Bless him, Lord.
Talking to you right now.
sins. Just say, forgive me, Jesus, and I'm sorry. Hallelujah.
Ain't no time.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Ain't it so good when the Holy Ghost comes in and he shows up? To know that Jesus is alive and that he's well. Glory to God. He said, I sit high and I look low. Glory to God. He said, I'll pick you up out of the othermost. I'll go all the way down to the fiery clay and I'll pull you up out of there. Glory to God. That's what Jesus said. The world calls him a fool. The world calls him a has-been. But one day they're going to call him the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Every one of the politicians are going to have to bow down to his knees and say, you are the King of Kings. And the Lords of Lords. This old world, glory to God, says that he's a myth, that he no longer exists. But I'm here to tell you tonight that he is alive, that he is well. He's not in a tomb somewhere. He's not on the cross no more. He has risen. And he sits on the Father's right hand. And he's making intercession for you and I tonight. Glory to God. He's saying, Father, you see what they are doing there tonight. God, you bless them. Hallelujah. That's my Jesus. My Jesus. That's who I serve.
Amen.
That's who I serve, Brother Joe, is Jesus.
Amen.
The risen Savior.
Right.
The King of Kings.
Amen.
Glory to God, the Bible said he's going to come back and he's going to have a vesture. Upon that vesture is going to be dripped in blood. And it's going to say King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Amen.
Man, I am stirred. Man, I'm so glad that the Holy Ghost walked in this place. I felt the mighty rush. You know what I'm gonna say? I felt the mighty rushing wind as he came in. Glory to God. I don't know about you, but it hit me right in the middle of my back. It went up to my head. Glory to God. And I tell you, I ain't nothing without the Holy Ghost. But when the Holy Ghost comes in, glory to God, he's a gentleman. We need to tell this world about Jesus.
Amen.
This world about Jesus.
Come on.
We need to tell them that he is alive.
Yes. Amen.
He is alive. He's no longer in that tomb. All the Jews and the Muslims says he's still in that tomb. But Jesus said, I'm alive.
and will. Glory to God. He said, I've seen it to my Father. Glory to God. And he's sitting up there. And he's waiting for them to say, I believe that he's no longer in that tomb.
Come on.
And when they accept that Jesus is no longer in that tomb, then the Son of Man's going to come.
Amen.
In a cloud. Glory to God. Man, I am stirred. I am excited. Hallelujah. Sister Rita, I am excited about what Jesus is doing. Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Bless him, Lord.
Man.
Bless him, Lord.
Man, I'm telling you what. I went to Mississippi, Brother Michael.
Help him, Lord.
I took my baby daughter down there with me and my son-in-law.
Help him, Lord.
And this man didn't even know my daughter from Adam, Sister Bunny. And every time he would start preaching, he'd walk right back here to me. And I'd say, Lord, let him call Cassie out. Don't let him call me out, just let him call Cassie out. Sister Rita and Brother Joe went with us. And he walked back there again, Sister Bonnie. And he stopped right there where I was at. And I said, Lord, let him call Cassie out. The next time he come back, he said, Sissy, come here. He said, God, show me that you're wanting more of him. You're hungry. You've got a hunger for the Lord. But he said, Sissy, took his hand and he went down in front of her like this right here. He touched her. He just went like this right here. And he said, the Holy Ghost has shown me that you've got a digestive problem. Nobody know nothing but me, her, and her brother, and Josh. She had that ever since she was a child. And he said, God is touching that. As soon as he laid his hand on her, boom, she hit the floor. She's been eating everything that she can eat. She's eating cheese, and she's eating cottage cheese. She's drinking milk. She's eating ice cream. She used to couldn't do that. But he didn't just stop there. He called my son-in-law. Come up there for prayer. He was kind of checking it out.
Skeptical.
And Cassie said, come on up here. He went over to him, laid his hands upon his head. Josh went out like an oak tree. There wasn't no way nobody could catch him. And as he went down, he said, brother, you better do what God's called you to do.
Amen.
Brother Joe, the Holy Ghost, been seeking the baptism for, what, 15 years? Drove 450 miles to receive it. Got down there.
He didn't give up.
And he didn't give up. He kept on and he kept on and he kept on. Man, they laid hands on him and all of a sudden the Holy Ghost came in. Just like it did right here.
Amen.
Brother Joe began to speak in tongues. Man, I seen a change in him, a difference in him.
Yes. Amen.
Tell me God ain't moving.
Amen.
God's a moving.
Yes.
God is a moving. Yes. Hallelujah.
You'll let him move.
And we said when we started this church, that we was going to let God be God.
Amen.
There was no time limit on God.
I
hate to say this, but it saddens me to know you go to a church for an hour and you come back home. It saddens me to know, glory to God, that you go to church for an hour and you turn around and go back home. Not giving God enough time to even work. not giving God enough time. And it's not the pastor's fault.
Help him, Lord.
It's the people that's in the seats. The pastor say, anybody got a song? No, no, no. So the pastor has to sing a song. And then he starts preaching. And when he gets done, it's done. It's not the pastor's fault. He does his job. He's done his work. But it's the people in the church that just says.
Thank you, Lord.
It says, I got it. When I got saved, I don't need nothing else. I got saved and I'm satisfied and I don't need to do nothing else. I don't need to pray. I don't need to go to the altar. Did you know I can go to certain churches and I can tell you who's coming to the altar and praying and who ain't?
Amen.
Because the same ones go to the altar all the time.
Yeah.
And the other ones sit back and say,
they move
me if you can. Man, look at that. They going up there and praying. Well, what's hindering that?
Yes.
What's hindering that? Because we went to a benefit just here the other night for Brother Keith Garvin. And we went to over here to Trinity over here on Lexington Drive. And there was 10 churches represented there. 10 different denominations there. And don't you know the power of God began to move in that church? And the pastor got on live stream Sunday morning, last Sunday morning, and he preached. And he told him, he said, God said for us to start praising Him.
Amen.
He said, when I seen all of the churches here together, praising God and worshiping God, he said, what's hindering us from worshiping God? What's hindering us from doing that? What's hindering us from being able to praise God and lift our hands? Hallelujah. I appreciate the Lord. I love Him. Thank God for what He has done here tonight.
Amen.
For what He has done.
Amen. Everybody came out.
I'm glad, like Lord said, we're glad that everybody came out. I'm going to let Sister Nora take it. If nobody wants to testify, I'm going to let her take care of that tonight.
Oh, yeah, my mic's
done. Well, that's all right. You turn it on. You just got to let Nora turn it on.
They're done in the church.
Well,
here.
Here. We're going to pray for the pastor's wife. Pray real hard for her.
I will.
You got a testimony. Just thank God for what He's done.
Well, it's a little bit of a story, but I was sitting in school the other day, and these two boys started talking, and they said, nobody's ever going to live forever. I looked out, and this is what I said. I sat there, and I told them, the one man is alive, and he's alive and well. It's Jesus. How in the world is anybody going to take Him from us? He's God's only begotten Son.
Right.
Like, for real. Are you going to sit there and lie to me and tell me that He's not alive because He's alive and He is well?
Amen. Amen.
I sat there and I got in a fight with Him, but I didn't throw fists. But I just said it verbal. I just sat there and I kept on and kept on and I finally started preaching. I sat there and I told Him John 3:16, which is, For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, whoever should believe in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Right.
And they got amazed. And I told them what happened to me at church last Sunday. And if they say anything else tomorrow, they're gonna have it in for them. Because I'm going to let them know what it's like to go to church and enjoy it instead of having to sit there, go for an hour, and then not come back, go home the same.
Amen.
And not have something different change in your life.
Bless Him, Lord.
Amen. Glory to God.
Okay.
I was just at school, and this didn't hit me until about now, when it was actually Wayne's preaching. One kid came and said, well, we're in school, and we're in hell, and now the fire-drill, we're going to burn it. I didn't think of this one. I'm like, boy, they really don't want to know what's going to happen if they really do go there.
Uh-huh.
And there was also another thing I was thinking. Tell all these people about God. This might get me kicked out of school, but that just might. It doesn't matter. If I do get kicked out of school, I'm doing it for a good reason.
You can always go back.
Amen. The basketball team was better. I told them about God. I got my sergeant major the courage you gave me, and my lieutenant colonel my wind teacher, so they might be coming to church at some point.
You told my sergeant major Jerks.
Yes, sergeant major Jerks.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He's strict, but he's honest with you.
Yeah,
amen.
I
don't place
him about that.
Amen.
I don't know if mom was here. No, she wasn't here, right? Not Thursday.
No.
No.
I think this was the day I said the biggest blessing I had was my mother and my family, because they're the ones who actually got me into church more and being able to actually love God. I said my other blessing was my brother, who can be able to give me any answer I need, and if I don't have an answer, I can go to someone else.
Amen.
We'll find someone who can.
Amen.
So I was just thinking, why are all these people not believing in Jesus when there's plain proof everywhere? They just want to sit back and do what they want. There's so many kids out there who talk about drinking like it's nothing and doing drugs. I'm like, one of these days they're going to regret that.
Amen. That's right. Amen. 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 Lord done something for somebody else tonight.
Come on, Sister Laura.
I just thank the Lord we got kids. And we've got parents that's bringing the kids up to know about the ways of the Lord.
Amen.
I thank the Lord for Daniel and Misty taking those two boys into their home and making them their kids themselves. You know, because that's all they was wanting was love. And Daniel Misty's giving them the love they need and trying to teach them about the Lord. Mm. And I thank them that they opened their home up to them two boys to make a difference in their life.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody else.
Hey, I was talking to Austin here the other day. I just thank the Lord for what I witnessed here today. I saw him, say yesterday, I guess.
Last night.
Well, whenever. I saw him in Austin. And, you know, we got talking about, you know, seeing people receive the Holy Ghost and seeing miracles perform in front of our eyes and God working. And, you know, if you say you're a Christian, especially if you say you got the Holy Ghost, and, you know, you witness what happened here tonight, and that don't touch you and that don't make you happy and give you joy in your heart, there's something wrong.
Amen.
Amen.
You need to get ready, like, you know, like y'all preach about. I just pray, ask y'all to pray for me, that I just trust and obey God, and just allow Him to work in my life and get me ready for when I do start preaching. So just remember us and just remember all the lost over
there. Amen. Amen. I told her,
Gavin.
Yes. Okay. Anyway, he knows what I'm talking about. I told him down in Boulder, and we went down to watch Heaven's Gates and Hell's Flame. And he come and he asked me, and Tanya done warned him about me. She said, now he ain't like all the rest of these people. He said, now he's strict. And he come and he said, will you use me in the church? And I said, yeah. He said, well, you know that I announced my calling to preach. I said, yeah. I said, but you know you're going to sit under some teaching before you get behind the pulpit. I said, too many preachers have been put up behind the pulpit and they're not preaching no more.
Right.
Because they didn't sit and be taught and hadn't been learned.
Right.
And I didn't say it hateful to him and I didn't say it in a bad way. I told him in love.
Right.
I said, you can come, we'll use you. I said, we'll let you take up an offering. We'll let you take up prayer requests.
Yeah.
But God had a different plan.
Yeah.
God's used him on the drums.
Yeah.
So see, God knows how to put you where you need to be.
Right.
And I just told him, I said, you sit under some preaching and sit under some teaching and read your Bible and study every day. Because
right.
The Bible said, study to show thyself approved.
That's right. Amen.
And That's the way I believe it. That's the way the Bible says to do it. And that's the way we're going to stand on it. What the Bible says. Sister Rita, that been put right up behind the pulpit.
Yep.
And where are they at today?
In the world.
They're out there in the world.
Charged.
Because they didn't set under some teaching.
Yep.
They didn't get enough teaching. They didn't get taught enough. I told him, I said, I sat under Brother Bill for 6 years before I went out and started preaching. 6 years. He said, you think it'd be that long? I said, no, I didn't say that. I just said, when God lets us know, then we'll know when it's time. And I said, well, you'll know when it's time.
Sorry.
Anybody else got a word of testimony?
I thank the Lord for being here, and I thank Him for what I felt tonight, and I'm thanking Him for moving in our home.
Amen. Go ahead, little sissy. I know you ain't shy. If I had a piece of candy dingling like this, you'd be, give me that candy. I want to say I'm glad to see Bonnie and Michael back with us tonight. I've said a lot of prayers, and I've never tried to push them. I've never tried to pull. I've just been praying. And I'm so glad that they came back tonight. Yes. Michael's one told me he was coming back tonight. Bonnie had never given me the answer. And Michael said, yeah, we'll be back tonight. Just bring them turnips tonight, and I'll just give them to church. So I'm glad.
Now,
anybody else want to testify?
You push and pull, you just being a little bit.
Anybody else got anything they want to say?
I'm glad for the Lord tonight. I'm glad for what He's done to this church. I'm glad for what He's done in my life and for healing me. Joshua has been a big change since we came back to Mississippi.
Amen.
And like I told Joshua and I told others, I believe there's going to be bigger and better things that's going to happen in this church.
Amen.
Y'all keep remembering her daughter first.
Amen. Yeah, we're glad Harry being back with us tonight. Her daughter. Amen. Anybody else got anything they want to say? Bake sale Saturday at Houchins at 8 a.m.
Let me know if you
want to
bake something.
If you want to bake something, tell Cassie.
Houchins
down there by
number one.
Yeah.
The big one.
That are Southgate.
Right.
Number one. Houchins. One, Connie said. And you don't have to come to this church if you want to bake something.
No.
Tell Cassie. But the 10th of December, Thanksgiving / Christmas dinner. For the ones that wants to come. You don't have to go to this church. If you want to come, you can come and be with us. Just bring a covered dish with you. Rita, if you bring Joe, make sure you bring a big piece. Come here, Joe. This is my buddy right here. Come here, Joe. Come here, buddy. Listen. It's cool right there. Joe Walden is my buddy. He's a wonderful charm. She was a miracle.
Well, I am. They know.
He's a miracle. He is a miracle.
Come in here, Joe.
A tractor turned over. Uh-oh. A tractor turned over on him. And his wife called me, and she was crying, and I couldn't hardly make nothing out. And she said, pray. Pray. She said, I said, what? She said, a tractor has fell over on Joe, has turned over on him. And I hung up the phone, and I called Brother
Terry Garrett
in Alabama. And I said, Brother Terry Garrett,
Georgia.
I said, Brother Terry Garrett, I said, if you can get a hold of the Lord, I said, y'all start praying. I said, a tractor has turned over on Brother Joe. And he said, Brother, as soon as I get off his phone, we're going to pray. He went and got his son. And they went to the church. Now, this was before I got the second phone call. And they went to the church and they began to pray. And while they were praying, we were praying, and Sister Rita calls me the second time. And she said, Brother David, she said, I don't know if he's going to make it. She said, they've got life flights on their way, and they're going to get him. And I got a call from Brother Terry Garrett, and he said, Brother, he said, Joe's going to be all right. Said the Holy Ghost spoke to my son and said, Joe's going to live and not die.
Amen.
Joe's right here tonight. Joe is right here tonight because God sent an angel down and saved him, kept him safe. Glory to God.
Right.
That's what I wanted to say about Joe.
Amen.
He is a miracle.
Amen.
World, I want you to know out there that here's a miracle right here.
Amen.
Because the doctors told him up there in Louisville that most people don't walk away from that. They don't leave the hospital. But he left the hospital.
What, the next day?
3 days after that, he left the hospital.
Amen.
And came home. That's a miracle.
Amen.
Say miracles ain't happening. Yes, they are.
Amen.
They're still happening today.
Amen.
Love you, buddy. I love him today. He's my buddy. Appreciate each and every one of y'all. Michael back here, he's my buddy. He's my drowning fish buddy.
Like the keys in the car, buddy.
Yeah. Yeah. Appreciate the Lord. Love each and every one of y'all.
November the 30th.
November the 30th, Brother Wayne says, is dedication service for the church. It's we're going to dedicate the church to the Lord.
The building.
We're going to dedicate it to the Lord and give Him thanks for what He has given us. And we're just here to worship Him. Anybody else got anything they want to say before we get... Sister Pastor's wife, you got something you want to say? Amen.
I'll be back
saying it,
son.
Hallelujah. I'm going to say she's going to be back
sometimes.
Brother Austin.
I just want to thank the Lord that from last Sunday to this Sunday, I got filled with the Holy Ghost Sunday. Thursday, I got in touch really good. And then this morning and tonight, I don't think I've ever prayed so hard as I did tonight, people, that I done about fell over 5 or 6 times. Stuck with this and right here on the altar till I felt that He was done. The Lord told me to tell Him things, and I did. And man, that's good to let that out. I tell you this, you can't keep the Holy Ghost bottled up inside. If you keep it bottled up inside, either it's going to come out of you, or you're going to get up and you're going to come out of your shoes. I'm going to start doing what the Holy Ghost tells you to do and start listening to God's Word. It's not just chastisement that you got to deal with. It's the fact that if you don't listen and do His Word, then you're going to fall back on it. And that's not a good feeling, because I've done that before, falling out of church, and then when I come back, it was that much harder for me to try to get closer. But then when I started to get, I was like, I should have done this before. I should have done this before. And now, just from this week alone, I've seen many things. I've had to fight many things. And believe it or not, I'm the only one in the whole house that ain't got sick.
Amen.
So,
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. I want to say, you know
he's
got the Holy Ghost, because it would be like pulling teeth to get him up here to sing. He's done 2 services.
Probably been like me until I spoke up.
Brother Daniel, you want to dismiss us?
Lord, thank you for today. Thank you for the church service. I ask you to go with everybody up home on the way back. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.